Now, like I said yesterday, if you're a blogger or someone who deals in online content, yesterday and the other day were times for you to get traction for your business. Because Stella Nyanzi was training, and even up to now, you can look at her Facebook page. She's getting tens of thousands of comments and, you know, of course, big likes there. If you follow up the story, use it well, you might get some good traction for your website. And that means money in your pockets. In the studio, I have a very good, person here. This is Brian, who also is a co-founder of howwe.biz. And of course, I'm thinking you have milked the Stella story so much. It's got you some big money there. But what do you think about, you know, from the business point of view?
Yeah.
What do you think about this whole story?
I wouldn't complain about whatever is going on because, like you say, from a business point of view, I really care less. I care about what the stories are bringing. So it brings us traffic, we make money. So that is on the business point of view. And they do things, we get stories right.
Where do you draw the line, you know, between a story that sells you and morality?
Good question, but you see, when you're trying to sell out news, your concern is about which story is going to sell most and which story is coming in which way. Of course, you're not going to make up stories. That's why we don't. And that's why when she does such a thing, we don't complain and say, on a business point of view. Because everyone is selling this story. We don't actually really
Do you care about someone's dignity? This is a professor who's a lady, and I've seen you posting about the videos and photos and all that. Do you have that in mind of, this is a woman, let me not put this photo up
online? If you ask me to review, to review the whole story, to review everything she's done, I wouldn't write supporting whatever she's doing, or maybe supporting whatever is happening to her, or maybe saying we need more of this nakedness, this kind of nakedness. No, I wouldn't write on that view. That would be my personal review. I wouldn't. For business, she does that. She has done a lot of things. People, I don't know why people are getting so surprised that she stripped. People just, I think maybe it excited a lot of people and shocked very many, but it didn't for me.
I
saw it coming. I knew, because she has threatened to cut off it. You know, am I allowed to say?
Well, you can. It's just a lifestyle.
Yeah, she has threatened to cut off her if Museveni wins. She has threatened to roast her private parts. She has threatened to stop masturbating if Museveni stays in office, something like that. She has done a lot of crazy things on social media, posed a lot of threats. And if you really were shocked that this happened, then maybe you didn't follow up, whatever.
I just want to ask you something related to the photos and the content you use. For example, I'm sure this is not a cartoon, it's from how we did how do you get the copyright to use someone's content?
Okay, here's the thing. Usually when we use a photo that we know, if the photo is copyrighted, of course almost every photo is, but if we know the owner of the photo, or the photographer, or the person who actually owns the photo, we credit them when we are using the photo.
Does me crediting you for your story give me the right to use your story?
It's a lot. It's crediting someone. It means like a tip of the hat. You've given respect to someone for their content, and you're acknowledging that the content, be it a photo or a section in your news post, that this content is not mine, and I'm crediting the source. That is allowed in media. You can quote a website where you've gotten the unless they've explicitly say down that do not use this content unless you've contacted us, like that. But that's going extreme. Usually when you get, when we get a certain, when we say, when we are on Urban TV watching, and then you say something, and maybe you're interviewing someone, if we are going to use that information, we quote that maybe according to this, or while being hosted at this, or while appearing at this. So we credit the source, and that is very important, because you're giving someone acknowledgement.
Now, of course, you know, as we sign out, I know there are many celebrities you've written bad stories about.
Yeah.
And I know there are people whose black books are full of how it is, and all that.
But that happens.
How do you deal with such an atmosphere of every day you wake up and all you do in your gossip column is to bring out the bad side of people's lives?
Actually, sometimes there is a point where I felt so bad. At some point, we wrote a story about some lady, and she lost her job. And we had the story. Of course, on the business point of view, you're very excited because you have the exclusive. But then on a personal point of view, you look at the story and see the results, the damages it has caused. It's a true story no one will ever sue, but after you see the repercussions, the damages that have been caused by a story. Sometimes you get personal, but in business, you're not supposed to get so personal.
Of course,
you just have to do business, and when you go
and that
there,
is
you,
when,
can,
of course,
you can mourn. You can mourn later.
That's when,
of
course, Pastor Bugendo will ask you all for Kadi. But anyway, as we sign out, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and all other social media networks, what works for you as How We Biz?
Facebook. Because it's the giant social media, of course. Mm-hmm. With Twitter, I think they are also trying to implement, they have the timeline of Facebook where you can get the post that you missed, or you can view this that you missed this, which is a good idea, but you know, people were used to tweets, going like, when you miss a tweet, it's gone, you either search it or you don't find it. So people have been used to that, and they reacted negatively to Twitter having introduced the timeline, but I think it's good. But for Facebook is very clear. When someone has subscribed to your page, which is following or liking a page, if they follow it a lot, they are going to always see the news feed. And it helps not only how, it helps a lot of bloggers, a lot of websites, a lot of companies. I wouldn't imagine a world without Facebook right now.
Because you won't get paid. Because of Facebook.
You see, right now, that's why I give respect to those websites that started without Facebook around when the internet was still something of a luxury here in Uganda. You have internet. Oh, you're rich. You have internet. So, websites that started, I won't mention, but they are there. But I give them respect. And for us, we came, we found Facebook was there, groups. We used groups to build a brand. It took over a year to start getting recognized, but we never gave up. So it is majorly Facebook that did the role. Then when the website was already up and running, we introduced, we went to Twitter as well.
Wow. When my producer said you're coming on the show, I was shocked. I didn't know that you'd come on the show. Although, let me just make this, straight. I hope he changed that story and correct the name. It's not. It's not more than Willis. It's two different people.
That is so sad, and maybe I can apologize on behalf of the company that we got the name wrong. We are going to change it, but that is sad.
Do you believe in the story? Do you? Do you think the story was true? On the record?
You haven't denied the story. So I wouldn't say it's false, because no one has come out to say that's false information, except for the name. And if you didn't actually believe that it was true, you wouldn't focus on the name.
Should we go to court?
I wouldn't recommend that.
I think we should end the show here. Yeah. And of course, let me get out of your studio. Mm-hmm. But do not forget to just keep watching Urban. It's a lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Follow me at Willis Daily. Head back online, but don't forget to still be nice.